Good morning, students. In today's class of management change in organization, we'll understand about a new topic, that is, what are the various forces of change. In the previous class, we have studied what is organization change, and we have studied that it is the change which the organization wants to move from its present state to its future desired state. This is known as organization change. We have studied how the organization's change happens at all the levels, technological, human resources, all the levels we have studied. And also we have studied what are the various types of organizational change, what is planned change, unplanned change, reactive change, proactive change, remedial change, incremental change, so transitional change, so transformational change, all these kind of various changes. What does the change entails? We have already discussed. And in today's class, we'll discuss about what are the various forces of change. The forces of change can be both external and internal. The forces of change are nothing but the pressures that the organization feels that forces an organization to change. So these are the various factors that impact the organization change, or these are the factors that impact or put pressure on the organization, so they are bound to change. So these factors are known as the forces of change. So let us briefly understand what is the exact definition or explanation of forces of change. Forces of change. Organizations today face a dynamic and changing environment that in turn requires these organizations to adapt. So in today's dynamic and changing environment, the organization needs to be on their toes. They need to require and adapt themselves as per the changing or the dynamic environment in which they conduct their business or operations. Change has become the norm in most organizations. In today's organizations, change has become one of the most important norms. It has become the basic rules or the essence in all organizations today. Organizations have to anticipate or respond to forces of change to be successful in the long run. So in order to be successful in the long run, the organization has to either anticipate these forces of changes and make changes in the organizations accordingly, or respond to these forces of changes. So they may proactively anticipate these changes and make the forces, the factors that will affect the organization, to make changes in the organization, or they may react in a reactive way. Okay, so once the factors affect the organization, then they are bound to change. So they may either anticipate or respond to the forces of change in order to be successful in the long run. So they have to, in order to be successful in the long run, they have to anticipate or respond to these forces of changes. The force of change can come from many sources. Okay, some of these are external, arising from outside the company, whereas others are internal, arising from sources within the country. So these forces of change can be, or these factors of change which puts pressure on the organization, may come either from outside the organization, which is known as external change, external forces of change, or this may come from the inside of the organization, arising from the sources that are within the organization. Then it will be known as the internal forces of change. Now we'll understand what are the types of forces of change. There are two types we have discussed. One is external and next is internal. So we'll discuss with what are the external forces of change. The external environment affects the organization both directly and indirectly. An organization operates in an environment, and this environment has an external environment which affects the organization both directly or indirectly. Okay. We have to understand what are the ways in which it affects directly and indirectly, and make changes in our organization in such a way that they are able to cope up or face with this external environment. The organizations do not have any control over the variables in such an environment. So why this external environment is important to understand? Because the organization do not have control over the various variables or variables, pressures, various factors or various forces of external forces of change. Since they are not under the control of the organization, they have to change as and when the external environment changes. So they have to be very dynamic, and they have to understand and keep a tap on how this external environment is operating and how it is impacting the organization. The organization cannot change the environment, but must change them to align with the environment. So as we have said that these are the external forces of change which are not under the control of the organization. Obviously, the organization cannot change the environment, but themselves have to align with the environment. They have to change according to the environment. They have to adapt to the environment, because if they do not adapt to the environment, they will not be able to survive in the long run. They will perish. They will be overtaken by the various competitors, and they will be out of business. So in order to stay in business, in order to be sustainable, in order to make profits in the long run, the organizations have to align themselves to the changes that is happening in the environment, because environment is something which is not under the control of the organization. So they have to adjust themselves according to the external environment. Now coming to the second type of forces of change, that is internal forces of change. So an organization may change because someone on the inside thinks a new way of doing things will be beneficial or even necessary. So these changes occur because of certain sources that are inherent or internally present in the organization itself. And it may be some person who thinks that a certain way of doing things has to be changed, which is beneficial for the organization, or sometimes it may be even very, very necessary for the organization. That means if there is a technological change in the environment, they feel that the external environment has changed, and internally they feel that the people in the organization, they are not having enough technological know-how, then internally they may feel the need that there is certain training and development required in the field of technological development, and they need to train and develop their staff in order to be sustainable in the market. So these are the things that are internal or inside the organizations. It may be some person, it may be certain forces, and it will force an organization to make changes. So these are known as the internal forces of changes. These are the pressures for change that originate inside the organization and are generally recognizable in the forms of signals indicating that something needs to be altered. So these internal forces, they send these recognizable signals. These are recognizable by the form of signals that they send and indicate that there is something that needs to be altered. Something change has to be made so that the organization will be viable, the organization will be able to face the environment and be able to be important in the existing market and have a share in the existing market. So these are the pressures, they are originating from the inside the organization. These are the forces of changes over which the organization has control, and the organization can make changes according to their desire. So what is the present state and what is the expected desired state they want, accordingly they can make changes in by using the various internal factors of the internal forces of change. Now we'll be understanding the external forces of change in this class. We'll start, there are many forces, external forces of change. Each and every point will be discussed in coming slides. So when we discuss about the external forces of change, the first thing that helps, that impacts the organization is the marketplace factors. So how the marketplace, these forces and organizations to change. So we'll understand the organization operate in volatile market. Obviously, no market is completely stable. All markets are volatile. They keep on changing. So the organizations have to operate in this dynamic and volatile market. So they have to be prepared for the changes in the marketplace. The various market forces related to buyers and competitors affect competitive position of the organization. So there are various market forces, and these market forces are related to two things. Either they are related to the buyer or they are related to the competitor. And these both the forces, these market forces related to the buyer and market forces related to the competitor, they affect the competitive position of the organization. Because if the organization wants to be competitive in the market, if the organization wants to have a bigger share in the market, they have to understand what are the various market forces that are affecting the buyers. And they have to change accordingly so that they may be able to attend or cater to the needs of the buyers. And also they have to understand what are the various market forces impacting the competitors, because if the competitors change or make changes in their organization, then they become much more effective and efficient as compared to their organization, then it will be a drawback. So we have to also keep an eye about what our competitor is doing, how the competitor is understanding the market forces and changing. So we have to be, in order to be having a competitive position, in order to be having a fighting chance, we have to understand the various marketplace factors. So these marketplace factors stimulate the organizations to change in order to remain competitive in the market. So this is the most important thing, because the organization wants to remain competitive, the organization wants to remain prominent in the marketplace, they have to change, and this marketplace factors stimulate the organizations to change. The factors related to buyers, we have discussed that the market forces may be related to buyers or competitors. So what are the factors related to buyers? The factors related to buyers are demand. If the demand, how the demand changes in the marketplace, we have to understand, because if we produce products or services for production services which are having no demand, it is of no use. So changes in the consumer taste and preference, if the people are not requiring the particular product, that taste and preferences are changing, then accordingly we have to change the income of the consumer. We have to see that we have to make changes and provide the products or service as per the requirement of the people. If we give an example, in today's laptops that we are having today, they are becoming much more thin, much more light, and they are becoming much more faster. They are removing this optical drives from these computers. Why? Because nowadays people need these thin, light laptops, and which are also consumer friendly, in the sense they are not very pricey. So the new type of laptops have come into market. They are in the shape of tablets, and also Chromebooks have come up. 2-in-1 laptops have come up, which can be both be converted into a laptop and also into a tablet. So here you have to understand that since the demand of the people are changing, buyers are changing, and if there is a change in the preferences of the people that prefer one that the laptops to be able to be mobile enough so that they can take anywhere. So the sizes of the screen sizes are changing. Most of the laptops are powerful laptops are coming with 13-inch, 12-inch, 14-inch of screen sizes. So, and all these laptops are being priced very competitively so as to attract people. So depending upon the income of the consumer. So these laptop manufacturers, they have to understand these marketplace factors. They have to understand the demand of the buyers, and accordingly they are making changes. So this is an example how the factors of the marketplace affects the buyers, related to the buyers. Now we'll understand what are the factors related to the competitors. Factors related to competitors are policies of competitors, better products and suppliers. We have to understand how the competitors are using better policies, new advertising policies, new policies of giving EMIs to the people so that they can make purchases and pay later during the period of COVID. Now it is going on. So various automobile companies are coming up with plans and policies where you may buy the car now, but you may pay at a later period of time, or there is EMI holiday for certain months, and then you have to start paying after 4 months or 5 months or 6 months. So all these things are coming up because they need that the product should be sold in the market. And since in the COVID situation, people are so much less cash is there in their hands. They don't have money to spend on luxurious goods. So they are coming up with new policies in order to attract these customers so that they buy the automobiles. They are also coming up with better products. Also, we have to look how the competitors are using the suppliers, how they're cutting down costs. These are all important for the competitors' point of view. So we have to keep a tab on how the marketplace factors affect the buyers and the competed. This is very important to understand. Now, another thing, new companies promote diversification, product deletion, disinvestments, and core competence to gain distinct advantage. Okay, this is present for new companies also. This marketplace is very important because they'll understand how to diversify their products, how they will see that a particular product is not much more viable in the present marketplace. They need to make changes or disinvestment in the doing disinvestment. How to make changes in the core competence of the product so as to get the distinctive competitive advantage over the companies. All these things are required both for a organization that is already in business or any organization that is entering or a new company entering into business. So the marketplace factors affect both of them. Now coming to the second external force of change, that is technological factors. The modern world is constantly changing. Technology, information system, computerization and decision support. All these things are changing. So there is constant change of technology. New technologies are coming in to play due to huge research. The technology is changing. The information systems are changing. The computer systems are changing. All things are nowadays computerized. So computerization has done. And similarly, a lot of systems are there which helps in the taking us the decisions. So the decision support systems are also changing. So all this technological change in the technological factors in the modern world is impacting the organizations, and the organization have to make changes in order to be remain competitive in the market. If organizations fails to update their technology and management information system, they will not be able to survive in the market, because people today require to come up with products that are much more technology driven, that are using the latest technology, and the management information system should be also latest, because this requires the organization to be survive in the market, be competitive in market, to be relevant in the market. So we have to change as per the technological changes. Both the organization and their employees will have to become more adaptable. So these technological factors are not only impacting this organization as a whole, but also impacting the employees that are working in these organizations. Many jobs will be reshaped. The jobs are being reshaped. Previously, individual jobs which were individuals who used to do routine, specialized or narrow jobs are now replaced by workers who are able to perform multiple jobs or multiple genres actively participate in decision making. So this is the kind of requirement that is present felt in the marketplace because of these technology factors. Today, any person who is joining as a manager or joining as a intern, whatever post, they have to be very properly understanding the various technological factors. They must be understanding the computers, use of technology. So the jobs are changing. You have to have a lot of, not only the organization need to change because of these technological factors, a lot of jobs are also being reshaped. And as the jobs are reshaped, the employees are also need to be much more adaptable. They need to understand these technological factors changes. They have to come up with new training and development courses so that the organization employees are also able to upgrade themselves as the technology upgrades. So what the management has to do, the management will have to increase their investment in training and education of these employees, because the employee skills are becoming obsolete more quickly. So the previous employee skills which were required to do the job are becoming obsolete quickly, and new jobs are coming up, new responsibilities are coming up, new job specifications are coming up. In these situations, as the technology factors changes, we as management, if you are part of management, they have to make huge investments or increase their investments in training and educating these employees, because training and development of the employees is required so that the employees are in the same page and they will understand what are the technological factors are there, how it is impacting the organization, and how they have to be technologically sound enough to operate in the or work in the organization. So this is the second external forces of change. Now coming to the third external force of change, that is the social factors. Because an organization does not operate in an isolate way, does not operate in a unique place. It operates in a society. So it is obviously, if it operates in the society, it has certain duties towards the society and is also impacted by the social and cultural environment. Thus, the social and cultural environment also suggests some changes that the organization have to adjust for. So the organization has to adapt themselves or adjust themselves as per the social and cultural environment in which they are operating. That is highly required. So there is a lot of social changes, like due to spread of education and knowledge and a lot of government efforts. The spread of education is that today most people are educated. So this is a social change which is impacting. So training has to be given to all the employees. The employees require that proper training should be given. Not only that, the management has to follow certain social norms in shaping its employment, marketing, and other policies. So the management has to make certain changes in order to adapt to the social norms in its employment, marketing, and other policies. If we say, for example, there is today, nowadays, there is a social equality or equal opportunities or equal pay for men and women has posed as a new problem for management, because previously, traditionally, management used to give less money to the women, but today these social factors have changed. So today the women are also more educated, they are also equally educated, equally capable, and equally performing in all the jobs. So the social equality is a challenge. So the companies have to change as per the social factors. Similarly, the organizations are the creations of the society, so they have to take care of the social factor. They have to make adjustment in their plans, procedures, policies, so that they will be viable in the organization, so that the people will, the buyers will, or the customers will see that the organization is being a part of the society, so they will be much more interested towards buying products from the organization. So these are the social factors that impact the organization. Now coming to the fourth forces of changes, that is the political factors of changes. So how the political factors affects the organizations to change. It is very important to know that the political factors also impact the organization, because the political factors are the factors which make changes in the rules and regulations in the existing format. So we have to be understanding what are the political factors and how they impact the organization. So business enterprises and government actively interact with each other. So these business enterprises or business organization have to actively participate with the government or interact with the government, because they operate as per the rules and regulations of the government. The changes in government policies with respect to taxation or corporate governance, new laws, and court decisions require the organizations to change their policies according to these regulations. Since the government makes the various rules, regulations, policies, so if they make the changes in the taxation policy or in the way corporate governance will be handled, some new court decisions comes which forces the organizations to make changes in their policies so that they are operating within the confines of the law, within the rules and regulations that have been set up by the government. So the organizations have to understand these political factors, these external forces, political forces, factors or political forces of change, and they have to make changes in their policies, procedures, in order to be viable, in order to be relevant, and in order to be properly legally working as per the government rules and regulations. The political environments within and outside the country have important impact on business, especially transnational corporations. So those organizations that are operating in many countries, they need to understand the political situation and how the political factors are impacting the organization in these various organizations, in these various countries, because they cannot remain away from these political situations, and they're impacted by the changes in the political situations. So also, this is especially important for these transnational corporations who operate in various countries to understand that. So this is the fourth point. The organizations, the political factor, the organizations do not have control over it, because these political parties, as per the elections, they keep on changing. So these organizations do not have control over these political and the legal forces that is at play. So the organization have to adapt themselves in order to meet to this pressure of the the external pressure. Now coming to the fifth forces of change that is available or that impacts the organization or forces and organizations to change is the global factors. So these factors also impact the organization to change and forces an organization to change. So globalization and liberalization require changes in the policies of organization to compete with the multinational corporation operating in the home country and the host country. So these global factors are also impacting the various organizations to make change in their policies. Because the organization, due to this globalization and liberalization, they enter into new markets, but they have to operate as per the rules and regulations of the particular country. So the multinational corporations operating in the home country has to understand the rules and regulations in the home country and also understand the rules and regulations in the foreign country or the host country. So they have to make changes both in the rules and regulations and policies in the home country in which they operate and also the host country in which they do that or conduct that business. Companies of different countries have different cultural and social values. This is very important. Why these global factors impact? Because the same thing that is acceptable in a foreign country may not be accepted or in a host country may not be acceptable in the home country, or the same thing which is acceptable in the home country may not be acceptable at the host country. So let me give you an example. As I've already given an example in other classes also, we have seen that how McDonald's had to make changes, or for that matter how Kellogg's had to make. Initially when Kellogg's entered into India, they were not able to go to the market and make changes in the market, but people were not considering Kellogg as a breakfast cereal. They were not accepting that. The people of India are much having a different reasons, have different ways of doing breakfast. But then Kellogg's entered into market by telling that this is good for health and it helps contain so many vitamins and how it is helpful for the children to grow. So all these things help to Kellogg to enter into the market. Similarly, if you take the example of McDonald's in America, the McDonald's selling both hamburgers, beef burgers and other things, but in India they had to make changes to their product because these are the global factors come into play. In India, people do not eat ham or do not eat beef or do not eat pork, so they had to make change, and beef also they do not, some people do not eat, so they had to come up with new burgers, new kind to taste the palate of the or taste of the Indians. Like they came up with paneer chicken, aloo tikki, all these kind of new burgers they had to come up with, new products they had to come up with. So the global factors impact the organization, and the organization has to understand this, that how the same rules that are applying in the home country may not be applying in the host country. So the companies of different countries have different cultural and social values, and the companies have to make changes in order to be viable in that host country. Since they interact with each other in the globalized world, changes have to be made in the organizational processes to be interactive with each other. So since in a globalized world they have to interact, this country, this people, they have to interact with these people, they have to make some organizational changes in processes, organizational processes, in order to be interactive with each other. So this is another external force of change. Now coming to the another for external force of change, that is the natural factors. How the natural factors impact the organizations to change. So organizations are open social systems and cannot ignore the impact of their operations on the society. So they operate as a part of the social system. They operate in a society and they cannot ignore the impact of their operations on the society. So when an organization operates in a society, it has certain impact on the society. As the society has an impact on the organization, which you have studied in social factors or social cultural factors or the global factors, there are also some natural factors that how the organization, their operations impact the society. Natural calamities like floods and earthquake also require changes in the policies of the organization. There are certain calamities that shake the society. and also check the operations of the organization in which it, because the organization operates in that society. So the organization have to make certain changes as per the policies, changes in the policies in the organization. As per, if you, let me give an example, a very relevant example will be the present situation of COVID. As per the present situation of the COVID, the organizations were not prepared for COVID-19. So they had to make certain changes in their policies. They had to give various support system to the people to work from home. They had to divide the work, and also some companies had to shut down certain operations or remove certain people. So all these changes in policies had to come up because the organizations are operating in a situation which was not previously there. So these natural factors, they also impact the organization, and the organization has to change accordingly. Social responsibilities are part of the organizational operations, which change according to the needs of the environment. So since the organization is operating in the environment or the society, they have certain social obligation or social responsibilities towards the society. They cannot ignore that. So these social responsibilities are part of the organizational operations, and these changes have to remain according to the needs of the environment. Like providing of medicine, clothes, food, monetary help may not be part of the organization's social agenda, but natural factors may require it to do so. So not only from the point of view of ethics, but also from the survival point of view. So many in this present situation, the companies had to give medicines, clothes, food and monetary help, not only to the organization employees, but also the people who are in need. Because the this is not the part of the social agenda of the organization, because these natural factors require it to do so. The organization have to make changes or do certain changes in the organizational policy because the natural factors force it to do so. And this is required not only from the point of view of ethics of the organization or the social responsibility of the organization, but also for its survival. Because if the society does not survive, if the employees do not survive, then how the organization will survive, and how, because the organization operates in the society, so it will not be able to survive. So natural factors also impact the organization to make changes to their policies, plans and procedures. Okay, we have discussed around the 6 factors of external forces of change. There are other factors of external forces of change and also internal forces of change that will be dealing in the next class. Go through the various notes which I'll be sending you digitally. No need to panic. Prepare at home. And finally, thank you for your attention.